Hi, I'm Jeff Stengbiel, Chief Technologist at KeyCode Media. We're going to talk about some key considerations when you're purchasing an LED wall today. As an audiovisual engineer, purchasing an LED wall requires careful consideration of several essential aspects. It's going to be crucial to take note of the critical factors that are going to impact the LED wall's overall performance. Things like pixel pitch, viewing distance, brightness, resolution,
refresh rates, power consumption, heat, electrical requirements, indoor versus outdoor use, IP ratings, and the type of LED wires that are used.
A lot of things to think about. KeyCode Media team has seen the demand for LED display design and installations exploding, with specific use cases for government, EOC rooms, sports arenas, cinema and television, public signage and retail, corporate conference rooms, houses of worship, things like hospital signage, bars, and restaurants. If you've got an interest in learning more, please don't hesitate to contact your preferred systems integrator, KeyCode Media. All right, let's dive into pixel pitch. The pixel pitch is going to be the distance between the centers of adjacent pixels. The smaller the pixel pitch, the higher the resolution possible in that screen. For instance, an LED wall with a 1.5 millimeter pixel pitch is going to provide twice the resolution of a 3 millimeter pixel pitch screen. So, minimum viewing distance. The minimum viewing distance is the shortest distance at which the screen's image can be viewed without any visual distortion. How close can someone get? This minimum viewing distance is going to depend upon the pixel pitch and the overall screen size. Brightness. So the overall brightness of an LED wall is going to be measured in something known as nits, or candelas per square meter. That's CD/m² for the math-loving peeps out there. It's going to be a measure that determines your screen's visibility in different lighting environments. For outdoor installations, a brightness of 5,000 nits or more is going to be recommended. If you're dealing with an indoor installation, a brightness of 1 to 2,000 nits is typically going to be sufficient. So, for reference, a normal television at home watching regular TV, it's 100 nits. That's some brightness there. Resolution. The resolution of an LED wall is the number of pixels in the display, which is going to determine the clarity of your screen's image. For instance, an LED wall with a resolution of 1920 by 1080, which is known as full HD, can display full HD content without any scaling. The refresh rate is the number of times per second that the screen is going to update its content. A higher refresh rate produces smoother images and reduces motion blur. For instance, an LED wall with a refresh rate of 120 Hz can display fast-moving content without any lag, judder, or flicker. 120 Hz is 120 times a second. Power consumption. You're going to have an average power consumption and a maximum power consumption. Power consumption on any LED wall is measured in watts. It's going to depend upon what the screen size is, the brightness, and the particular configuration you're using. It's going to be essential to consider both the average and the possible maximum power consumption to ensure that the display doesn't overload your power supply. For instance, an LED wall with an average power consumption of 300 watts and a maximum power consumption of 1,000 watts is going to need power supply that can deliver at least 1,000 watts. Heat, or BTUs. The heat generated by an LED wall depends on its power consumption and the environment where it's installed. The BTU rating measures the amount of heat generated by the display, and it's going to be essential to consider it to ensure that your screen doesn't overheat. For instance, an LED wall with a BTU rating of 4,000 requires a cooling system capable of dissipating at least 4,000 BTUs per hour. That's a third of a ton in additional air conditioning for the space in case you were going to do the math. Electrical requirements. The electrical requirements of an LED wall are going to include things like voltage, amperage, and frequency. It's going to be essential to ensure that the display's electrical requirements are going to match those of the power supply to avoid any compatibility issues. So it's possible to get a LED wall that's going to need to run at 50 Hertz. In the United States, all our power runs at 60 Hertz, so you need adequate power at 50 Hertz to generate that sort of signal. Generally, here in America, we're going to need to worry about the voltage, whether it's going to be 220 or 110. If it's 220, you just simply need to make sure you have the circuits available to power the wall. If not, you're going to have a chat with an electrician. If you don't want to have a chat with an electrician, make sure you get a 110-volt wall and you won't have to worry about that. All the power for these walls doesn't just come out of the wall that way all the time. So IP ratings, or ingress protection rating. IP ratings indicate the level of protection the system will have against things like dust and water. For outdoor installations, it's going to be essential to choose an LED wall with a very high IP rating to ensure that it can withstand harsh weather conditions. For example, an LED wall with an IP68 rating provides complete protection against dust and water immersion up to 1.5 meters. I don't know how much that is in snow. That's a lot of snow. So now we get to copper wire LED versus gold wire LED. There's two types of LED wire used in LED walls. Copper, like we're all used to, and gold. Gold is more expensive, but it offers better performance, such as higher brightness and a longer lifespan. Copper wire is going to be less expensive, but may not offer the same level of performance as gold wire. So to wrap all this up, purchasing an LED wall is going to require careful consideration of several essential aspects to ensure that the display is going to meet your requirements. By taking note of the factors we've mentioned above, you can select an LED wall that provides optimal performance and the best value for your installation. So if you need to have a chat about what those requirements are going to be, why don't you talk to some folks who know? Please don't hesitate to reach out to us here at Key Code Media.